Jai Bhim. I am Dhammacharini Jnanasuri. I born in 1942 in Nagpur in untouchable and poor family. Maybe very difficult to you understand what is untouchable. Hindu religion, we coming from very low caste and we can't touch other people and they also can't touch us because they feel that they polluted. And we do not have any rights, means living as a human being, living only like an animal. But due to Dr. Ambedkar, he always tell us, you are not animal, you are human being, and you have to struggle for your living like a human being. And that very much effect whatever Dr. Ambedkar said, people try to follow. So I'm very fortunate those days in Nagpur, very much influence of Dr. Ambedkar. He told people, give education to your children as well as daughters also. In Hindu religion, that time, Hindu ladies also can't take education. Their Hindu religions rule that. But Dr. Ambedkar very much press on that to give education to girls also. And due to him, I get education. In school, I have some experience of untouchables. I was very clever student in the class, but still, teachers avoid me. And sometimes give less marks. Then I cannot come first. Please try to understand, my English is not good.
It's very good.
Those days, means before conversion, maybe before 6 months or 1 year, Dr. Ambedkar very much pressed, we going to change our religion. And he tried to write, tried to give talk to people how and why we convert in different religion. Why we do not want Hinduism. So he tried to convince people. And when actually he is in 1935, he said that I'm going to change religion with my people. And I do not want to die in Hinduism. And from that time, he was studying different religions. And he chose Buddhism for him and for us also. And actually, that is not very easy thing to people, change religion. But they have very much trust on him. And people think whatever he said or whatever he doing for us, that is correct, and people try to follow. So those days very much people very much poor, and he said come to Nagpur for conversion. People do not have money, very difficult to travel from their village to Nagpur. So I remember 10-15 days before they start walking to Nagpur, or some people sold their roof for coming to Nagpur, and they only come with bhakri, bread, and not any vegetable, only salt. And that those days he said that you convert in Buddhism, so you have to wear white cloth. That is also very difficult for people buying white cloth. But somehow they managed. I remember my mother wearing white, but that my father going to pajama shivnarote. He buy cloth, white cloth for pajama. That cloth.
Trouser.
That cloth my mother wear that day. So like this, many ladies, many gents, however they try to adjust and they come to the that place, now we call Diksha Bhumi. And really thousands of people, we can't say how many. And very, that atmosphere was very devotional, very much, people have very much shraddha on Dr. Ambedkar. They do not know anything about Buddha. They do not know anything about Buddha's teaching. Yeah. What is Buddhism, they do not know. Only they have very much trust on Dr. Ambedkar, they're going to change their religion. And he take Diksha from Chandramani, the name of that guru. And he give the Diksha all people. This is very new thing. And that time he gives some 22 vows to the people. And that 5 vows about not to worship Hindu gods and goddesses. And I remember when people take that Diksha and come to home, they throw out the god and goddesses from their house. This is big step. And we very happy, we very confident, we not Hindu, we are Buddhist. Still we do not know anything about Buddhism, but still we happy. Next day when I went to school, teacher teasing me. Oh, now you Buddhist, what is mean that? I do not know what is mean that. But I feel, yeah, we are not Mahar now, we are not untouchable now, we are Buddhist now. And then they ask, what Kutla Sampradaya Diksha Ghetli?
Which school you belong to?
I do not know anything that time, but I very confidently giving answers. You people not treat us as a human being, so we all going to in Buddhism. So what happened? What is your problem? I asked to the teacher. So we are very happy that time. But after 6 weeks, Dr. Ambedkar passed away. And then we feel that I can't say what we feel that time. Means only म्हणजे पोरक झाल्यासारखं वाटलं.
As if we lost a beloved one.
Everybody crying very loudly. And some people means they म्हणजे जमिनीवर लोळत होते, रडत होते खूप जोर जोराने.
They were just lamenting actually, you know, rolling around on the floor.
And thinking what now happening with us. That day was 6 December 1956. And he was a very great man. He write the constitution. Still, when he died that day, our school not close. Then some people come to the school and they request our teacher to close the school because of Dr. Ambedkar died, and then school closed. In constitution, he wrote that means everybody is equal, but still in India there is very big casteism, still different way. Means they, we can touch them, they can touch us, we can eat, they can eat our food. But now very different in colleges, in schools, still there is very, very much much casteism. Yeah, people, why people hate us, we don't know. Maybe they do not like we growing, we developing. They do not like that because they want we always down. But now not going to happen that. Still very much anyay, injustice on our people. Only even on 5-6 months before, one 10th standard student, he only saw the other caste, high caste girl, and he tried to talk him. People killed him. Only he tried to talk. People killed him. This now also happening. So very difficult feeling. But when Baba Sahib passed away, we people very much sad about that. And Bhante come there. Yeah. And he help us to coming out of that sad situation. I remember when he was in Nagpur on 6th December and he giving talk. I not remember what he giving talk, but I was there with my mother. All ladies is there and some men, because all men go to the funeral to Mumbai. So I not remember, and I not remember I saw him, Bhante. But my mother said somebody, white man was there. So I come to know, and then after I read that. So what happened? What Bhante or what Sangha has done for us? We are Buddhist, but we do not know how to practice Buddhism. And do I very means khup krutajnyata purvak
feels very strong gratitude.
I feel very, very much gratitude, because due to him we come to know how to practice Buddhism in our life. In 82, my first retreat, as Charun Alika said, I have many questions because of situation like that. Why these people teaching us closing eyes and sitting? So that is a question in my mind. And why not they teach us how to protect ourselves? But really something in that retreat touched my heart. And I, from that time, I very much regular in retreats and every programs and everything. And I feel that still that time our Sangha start in India, but not up to that time ladies coming to the retreat or coming to the program. We are Buddhist, but still our mentality like Hinduism, not to go out. Husbands also not giving permission. If father, he also not giving permission to ladies go to the retreat or go to the program. I'm very lucky. My husband helped me. And I feel that I have to help other ladies. Help for how to practice Buddhism, how to develop as a human being, and how to do metta themselves, very much compassion themselves, because that is very need. We Indian ladies very different. We always think others first and then ourselves. So this is different thing, and then I come to know if not metta for myself, so how can I help others? And then I try to help ladies and try to convince come to class. I was Mitra that time also, I was leading class. So I convinced them. I try to meet their husbands and convince them to send their wife to the class. So this way starting movement, ladies movement in India. And from that, means now in India, 160 Dhammacharini and how many Mitra, I can't say. And near about 800 requests for ordination. Actually, our team very small, and that is big question in front of us, how to help all of them. But now we growing, and I hope we can help. Yeah. Women very much depend on their husband economically. That time, how to help them to come to the retreat? And I'm very, Krutajnita. I have very much gratitude, means Sangha, sometime Karuna help, and now IDT help us to go to the retreat and spread Dhamma in women. So work very big in India, not only for women, men also very big, because India is not small country. And when we try to convince people, that not easy. They have many questions, we have to give answers about that. And somehow we get success. And now in India, Sangha is very much growing. Ladies have get confidence, I can give some example. 2 months before, there was a ordination, woman's ordination, and there is one lady, she ordained. She is coming from a very poor family, and she is illiterate. She can't read and write. And very difficult. So she talk with me. That time also I feel, oh, she can't talk. So like that. But she very good practicing. And after her ordination, when welcome program in center, I surprised. She talk half hour in front of mic. Yeah. So big change means this confidence, how she get confidence. She feel that now I am something. I am responsible. And I am Dhammacharini. So when we see example like this, so I feel future of women in India very good. So I can give many examples like that, but I think we have to hear more about my brothers. Yeah.